Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are keeping fine and safe. So yes, let's start our video today. In this video, I am going to give you out a job notification which is out and you can fill it up. So the name of the post for this job is Gale India. Gale India Limited has applied, opened for a vacancy online and the form is available online for the year 2021. The date is 9/7/2021 and total number of vacancies is 220. I'll give you brief information about GAIL, which is the Gas Authority of India Limited, which has published notification for the recruitment of the post of manager, senior engineer and other vacancies on contractual basis. Those candidates who are interested in this vacancy, their details and other all completed eligibility criteria and other details are available in this video. You can read this the notification which is available in the website and apply, or also you can go through this video. This is all about Gale India Limited, a Maharashtrian PSU and India's flagship natural gas company, is integrating all aspects of the natural gas value chain, including exploration and production, processing, transmission and also distribution, with marketing also included here. And definitely it's related to related services. In a rapidly changing scenario, GAIL, which is the Gas Authority of India Limited, is spearheading the move to a new era of clean fuel industrialization by creating a quadrilateral of green energy corridors that connects major consumption centers in India with major gas fields, LNG terminals and other across borders gas sourcing points. GAIL, which is the Gas Authority of India Limited, is also expanding its business overseas to become a formidable player in the international market. Gale India Limited invites applications from Indian nationals fulfilling the eligibility criteria for filling up various posts as per the category-wise vacancies, including backlog vacancies which are available. The vacancy posts are manager for marketing, commodity risk management. The total seats available for this is 4. Next, we have the manager for marketing international LNG and shipping. The total number of posts available for this is 6. Next, we have senior engineer chemical. Total number of posts available for this is 7. Next, we have engineer for mechanical. The total number of posts available is 51. Then we have senior engineer electrical. Total number of posts available is 26. Next, senior engineer instrumentation, and the total number of seats for this is 3. Then we have senior engineer for civil, and the total number of posts available is 15. Next, we have senior engineer, that is the GAILTEL, TC or TM. The total number of posts available is 10. Next, senior engineer boiler operation, and the total number of posts available is 5. Next, we have engineer environmental engineering E2, O3, O1 and O2, and the total posts available is 5. Next, we have senior officer E and B, and the total number of posts available is 3. Next, we have senior officer FNS, and the total number of posts available is 13. Next, senior officer C and P department, and the total number of posts is 10. Senior officer BIS, and the total number of posts including senior marketing, senior officer marketing, is totally 8. Next, we have senior officer for HR department, and the total number of posts is 18. Next, we have senior corporate officer communication, and the total number of posts is 2. Senior officer law, and the total number of posts is 4. Next, we have senior officer FNA, and the total number of posts available is 5. Next, we have officer laboratory, and the total number of posts available is 10. Officer security, and the total vacancies are 5. Next, we have officer official language, and the total number of posts available for this is 4. So this makes it total 220 posts. Now I will talk about the terms and conditions in respect of the essential qualifications that is required and subscribed and the essential experience that is required and said by this company. So, the minimum essential educational qualification or qualifications required is indicated in the official website in Table 2 against each post of the vacancies. Only full-time regular courses will be considered except CA or CMA qualification. All minimum essential qualifications must be from UGC recognized Indian University or UGC recognized Indian deemed university or AICTE approved courses from autonomous Indian institutions or concerned statutory council or bodies wherever it is applicable. Diploma in engineering qualifications, if applicable, should be recognized by the respective state board of technical education related to the Indian university. Next, minimum percentage of marks is very essential in the essential qualifications as it is specified shall be considered as per the institute or university rules, regulations and norms. Next, wherever CGPA or OGPA or CPI or letter grade in a degree is awarded, equivalent percentage of marks should be indicated in the application as per the norms that is adopted by the university or institute. Candidates will be required to submit documentary proof or certificate to this effect from the institute or university at the time of interview if called for the same, that is if you are selected for this. Next, engineering degree can be BE or BTech or BSc in engineering. Candidates having 5 years of BE or BTech plus NE or MTech integrated dual degree in engineering in relevant discipline shall also be considered for this job. Candidates having 5 years of BE or BTech plus NE or MTech integrated dual degree in engineering is in this relevant discipline and 2 years of MBA with specialization in marketing or oil and gas or petroleum and energy or energy and infrastructure or international business shall also be considered for the post of senior officer for marketing. Next qualification, wherever MBA has been mentioned as requirement, apart from MBA, 2 years of postgraduate diploma in management with specialization in relevant field or MMS with specialization in the relevant field shall also be considered for this particular job. MBA or PG diploma in management or MMS qualifications where there is a mention of dual specialization, one of the specializations necessarily needs to be function specific for which the post has been advertised for. Next, minimum essential post qualification executive experience in state or central government or any other bodies or departments or organizations or undertakings and or large private sector organizations, that is the PSOs, page 15 to 25 institutions, company or companies of reputation, or CA or cost accounting firms of repute or large law firms should be as on 5/8/2021. Industrial or vocational training undergone as a part of course curriculum will not be considered against minimum essential experience criteria. So please take a note of it. The period of the apprenticeship training that is asked for by the company of other candidates in the relevant industry of state or the central government or the departments or the undertakings or the organizations or any other institutions or large private sector organizations or any other institutions or companies of repute or CA or cost accounting firms of reputation, large law firms as prescribed against the post will be considered as experience against the requisite post that the candidate is applying for, and the post qualification minimum essential experience criteria, subject to the fulfillment of all the other eligibility criteria as per the terms and conditions as mentioned in the official website notification. Next, large private sector organization or institution or company of repute shall include listed companies, which would mean and include companies listed on NSE or Group A and B of BSE, or organization or institution or companies with more than 500 employees or having an annual turnover of more than Rs 250 crore in the last financial year. Large law firms would include only such law firm having an annual turnover of more than Rs 10 crores in the last financial year. The candidates are required to submit suitable documentary proof to establish the same of the experience. Experience of the candidates working on contractual basis through empaneled agency or contractor, that is those who have been deployed on contract basis by some other institutions or some other agency, some other organization for working on project or construction or O&M or any other activity will not be considered. Only direct work experience, including fixed term basis employment in an organization, will be taken into the consideration. Next, I will talk about the relaxation in minimum percentage. Relaxation in minimum percentage of marks in educational qualification or qualifications. Yes, relaxation is provided in minimum qualifying percentage of marks and in essential qualifications in respect of scheduled caste or scheduled tribe and PWBD category candidates has been provided as per the criteria which I am saying right now. Wherever minimum qualification percentage of marks have been specified as 65%, relaxed minimum educational qualifications for the same categories is percentage in respect of scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and PWD candidate category candidates is reduced to 60%. Wherever minimum qualification percentage of marks has been specified as 60%, relaxed minimum educational qualification percentages for the scheduled caste or scheduled tribe and PWBD category candidates have been reduced to 55%. Scheduled caste or scheduled tribe or PWBD category candidates applying against unreserved post shall be considered under the general standard of merit, and no relaxation in minimum qualifying percentage of marks in educational qualification shall be available to these candidates. Upper age limit, talking about that. The upper age limit and age relaxation. Yes, The upper age limit for various posts is given in the table 2 as on the notification dated 5/8/2021. The upper age is relaxable by 5 years for scheduled caste or scheduled tribe category candidates with 3 years for OBC NCL page 16 or 25 category candidates. It is also relaxable by 10 years for PWBD candidates, EWS category candidates, 13 years for PWBD OBC NCL category candidates, and 15 years for PWBD SCST category candidates. The relaxation in upper age limit is applicable only in respect of posts which are reserved for scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, other backward classes NCL category candidates. Relaxation in age limit shall be applicable for PWBD category candidates irrespective of the fact whether the post is reserved or not, provided the post is identified suitable for the concerned PWBD category candidates. The upper age limit is also relaxable by 5 years for the candidates who are domiciled in the state of Jammu and Kashmir between 1/1/1980 and 13/12/1989. Scheduled caste or scheduled category or OBC NCL category candidates who are applying for the post marked unreserved, which is UR post, for the shall be considered under general standard, and no relaxation of merit and in upper age limit shall be available to them. So please have a concern about where you are applying from. In case of ex-servicemen who have put in not less than 6 months continuous service in armed forces of the Union, they shall also be allowed to deduct the period of such service from their actual age. And if the resultant age does not exceed by more than 3 years, the maximum age limit that is prescribed by this company for the post or services for which a candidate seeks appointment, he or she shall be deemed to satisfy the conditions regarding the age limit. Next, talking about the maximum upper age limit. Maximum upper age of the candidate or the applicant shall not exceed 56 years, including all possible age relaxations. Relaxation and concession for persons with benchmark disabilities, which is PWBDs, categories candidates will be in accordance with the government directives, rules and regulations in this regard. Next, talking about the emoluments. Yes, I'm sure you are waiting for this. The candidates who are selected shall be on a probation for a period of 1 year and shall draw initial basic pay in corresponding pay scales as E3 pay scale ₹70,000 to 2 lakh rupees, initial basic pay ₹70,000. E2 pay scale ₹60,000 to ₹1,80,000, initial basic pay ₹60,000. E1 pay scale ₹50,000 to 1,60,000, initial basic pay ₹50,000. Candidates to be selected for the position of senior officer or senior engineer in E2 grade through open advertisement on all India basis are offered minimum basic pay in the pay scale of E2 grade will be allowed 01 advance increment at the applicable rate presently at 3% over and above the minimum of pay scale in E2 grade which is offered to them. Candidates who are granted protection of pay basic plus DA, which is the durance allowance, will be allowed 1 advance increment at the applicable rate which is presently or currently at 3%. On cumulative basis over and above the basic pay which is fixed for protection of his or her last pay drawn. candidates granted higher basic pay in the form of advance increment by the competent authority on the recommendation of the selection committee will also be entitled for one advance increment as stipulated above over and above the higher basic pay offered to him or her on the basis of recommendation of the selection committee. Candidates who are selected for the position of senior officer or senior engineer E2 grade and possessing dual qualification, that is of BE or BTech and 2 years full-time regular MBA degree from a recognized or equivalent university or institution like MMS, PGDM, master's degree in personal management and industrial relations or social work or social welfare or PG diploma in personal management and industrial relations or social work or social welfare while joining GAIL will be allowed 2 advance increments at the applicable rate currently at the rate of 3% on cumulative basis over and above the minimum of pay scale in E2 grade which is mentioned as per the notification. All the candidates who are selected for the post of a senior officer or senior engineer in E2 grade through open advertisement on all the India basis and offered minimum basic pay in the pay scale of E2 grade having post qualification which is relevant to experience of 4 years or more than 4 years against the requirement of minimum post shall or the minimum post qualification relevant experience of 1 year will or shall be allowed to 2 advance increments or on cumulative basis at the applicable rate of 3% presently over and above the minimum basic pay in the pay scale of E2 grade which is currently carrying on. For the purpose of calculating the number of years of post-qualification or relevant experience, the last date for submission of the online application will be taken as the cut-off date. So, candidates granted protection of pay basic plus DA will also be allowed to 2 advance increments as stipulated in the above mentioned criteria I just told at the applicable rate of 3% on cumulative basis over and above the basic pay fixed for protection of his or her last pay or last withdrawn. Further, candidates granted higher basic pay in the form of advance increments by the appointing authority on the recommendation of the higher authority of the selection committee or otherwise on the merit of each case will also be allowed to 2 advance increments as stipulated in the above criteria at the applicable rate of 3% on the cumulative basis over and above the higher basic pay offered to the candidate. So I have given you all the payment criteria and all the eligibility criteria that is required for this job. If you think you are the best person to be applied for this job, then definitely go for it without wasting time and all the best for your career. So I hope you have liked this video. Thank you for hearing me out so patiently. Concluding my video here. Thank you.